Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to the first Sunday in Advent service for First Congregational United Church of Christ in Zimbabwe. On this crisp and clear day, warmer weather is coming, I understand. That'll be nice. That might be it for us. Fine. That might be the end of it. Yeah. Does anyone have any announcements they'd like to make today? Yes.
We as a church are participating in the Goodhue County Christmas Project again this year. And in the back of the church is information about the family that we are supporting. It's a single parent family with 7 children, ages 3 to 16, I think. And we participate with 2 other organizations, Goodhue County Social Services and the Toys for Tots program. Toys for Tots provides gifts for the children. We're providing clothing items and food items, including gift cards. So the sign-up sheet is in the back. Please sign up. Thank you.
Thank you. Are there any other announcements anyone would like to make? My announcements today are these. My first announcement is that we have, I believe, 3 trees left. 2 trees left. As of 9:38, we have 2 trees left. And we had 90, is that right? 90 that we put out last week? So 87 sold in this space of a week. And that's remarkable. And it really is a community building thing for people to be able to come here and get their trees and do that in our town, and all of us working together on that. I want to send a special thanks to the Paul family for their work in the tree sales, and Arlen and Neil, you set up the rack, is that right? Both of you did? Thank you very much for doing that. I have requested readers and candle lighters for the Advent season. And I'm happy to report that we have 1 opening left. 1 family or person who would like to read on Christmas Eve, read a story on Christmas Eve, there is 1 spot available. We have candle lighters for next week, the week following that, and then, as I said, we have candle lighters for Christmas Eve, and 2 readers already set for Christmas Eve, so we will need 1 more reader on Christmas Eve. If that's something that you or your family would like to do, please let me know, and I will make sure that you are in the service. My last announcement is that next Sunday, the second week of Advent, we will have candle lighting, and it will be the first week of the month, so we will be having communion. And we will also be having communion on Christmas Eve. Would you please stand if you are able? As I give the prayer of invocation. Holy One, Give us confidence in your promises. Give us confidence in your and our ability to make new beginnings. And give us confidence in the ability to go home to a safe and loving place. Amen. Please join me in singing our first hymn. Hymn 101, Comfort, Comfort, O My People. Our next hymn is hymn 103, Watcher, Tell Us of the Night.
Thank you. We feel like tired and scared fishermen and women alone on a boat in the middle of the sea. We don't know if we have the strength to face what is before us.
Show me the way to your
home. Home. The prophet Jeremiah speaks of a branch that will be raised. Jesus spoke of the Son of Man that will descend. Both point to a hope that calls us home, our true home, where we're welcomed and loved and included, where there is justice and equality and peace. It's time, this Advent season, time to go home.
We light this candle as a sign of our hope, our strong hope that there is a way to go home, to the home of Christ, and it starts with us, and it starts here, and it starts now. It's time to go home.
Thank you, Parker. Now, as we think about home, let's take some time out of our days and let's sit back and close our eyes if you're comfortable doing that. And let's be quiet and make space for God. Let's take some time and breathe in and breathe out and come back into this place. Our reading today is from the prophet Jeremiah, chapter 33, verses 14 to 16 on page 645 of the Pew Bible. And Jeremiah the prophet is talking about one who is going to come to Israel. verse 14. The days are surely coming, says the Lord, when I will fulfill the promise I made to the house of Israel and the house of Judah. In those days and at that time I will cause a righteous branch to spring up for David, and he shall execute justice and righteousness in the land. In those days Judah will be saved, and Jerusalem will live in safety. And this is the name by which it will be called: the Lord is our righteousness. This ends the reading. One of the themes today in the lighting of the Advent candle is home. And I think that we recur, or we go back to that theme again during this Advent season. For many of us, especially after Thanksgiving, when we can often be together as a family, and during Advent, as we lead up to Christmas, also a time of gathering in our homes. Home means certain things to us. It means safety and love and caring and consideration. Respect for others. For some, home doesn't carry these pleasant connotations. Perhaps one is homeless and on the streets. Perhaps homelessness and the streets are safer than what that person experiences in home. Unfortunately, that happens. For some of us, home is the best place that there is. And for some of us, it's not a safe place. It's a place where there is temper and volatility, and unfortunately, violence. When we talk about home during this Advent season, we're talking about home in the best sense, in the sense of a place where people are safe, and where people are welcomed and brought together, where they're secure and there is love and there is respect. And there is a place where we want to be together, one with the other, and share our experiences and share our lives. This Advent season, as we think about Jesus' birth, humble beginnings, in the manger, in the stable, because there was no room at the inn. Jesus tells us what home is. And that's what we mean when we say home this Advent season. We mean this. The first aspect of home is the place where there's God's love. And Paul, in Romans 8, said this. And I think it goes to what home is as well. Paul wrote, nothing. Nothing that there is in this world can separate us from God's love. If home is a great place for you, or home is not a great place for you, that's the first meaning of this Advent season is, there is a place for you here. There's a place for you in this world. And there's a place for you right here in this church. Because nothing can separate us, all of us here, nothing can separate us from God and God's love for us. Come with me. In the story of the Good Samaritan, in Luke 10, the writer of Luke talks about home in this world and how we should look at other people, how we should look at our neighbors and view them and act towards them. And we know the story of the Good Samaritan, where the Samaritan helps someone who is very different from himself. And he gave to that person, even though there were differences, and they were separate. But for the Samaritan, they were neighbors and they were the same. In that story, Jesus is talking about all of us. All of us in this world being at home, in the world. And looking at each other, even if they're different from us. As someone to respect, and more importantly, someone to love and care for. The prophet Jeremiah talked about the branch from the house of David bringing justice and righteousness and safety. When we view Jesus and look at Jesus' teachings, that's what he's talking about. Making that safe home, not just for us, but for everybody. That's what Jesus is telling us is our duty. If during your life, that's not the way things are for you, and the world isn't that lovely, peaceful, loving place, during this Advent season, and during the changes that we see, one thing that we know in our lives, regardless of what our experiences are, one thing we all have experienced and we all know is that change happens. And just because something is this way now, doesn't mean that it's always going to be that way. And if our homes are not the way we want them, or our neighborhood is not the way we want it, or our hometowns are not the way we want it, or if our world is not the way that we want it, change happens. And sometimes for change to happen, it needs a little bit of a nudge. Or a little bit of a kick in the pants. And during this Advent season, let's think about the change that we can bring in our homes and in our neighborhoods and in our hometowns. Thanks be to God. Amen. We now get to sing hymn 116, a beautiful hymn. O come, Emmanuel. 116. We will sing the first four verses. Verses 1 through 4. O come, O come, Emmanuel.
Thank you.
Now, during this time, let's share the joys and concerns that we have during the past week, the things that made us happy, maybe the things that made us sad. Anything you'd like to lift up, let's do that right now. Are there any things anyone would like to share? Yes.
One of our dear friends, Gail Strummel, he was a college classmate of Carol's, is in the hospital having both heart problems and nutrition problems. She can't take in nutrition well.
Esophageal
cancer. So a double. So healing and hope for Gail.
And how do you spell Gail's last name?
Strummel, Strmel.
Thank you. Are there any other people that we'd like to lift up? Would you bow your head, please, as they lead us in the prayers of the people? God, during this Advent season, when we're looking back on our year, and the joys and the sorrows that we've had, and we reflect on them, please keep us tuned in to the thought of what we have and the role that we can play to help others who might not have the same things that we have. Oh God, we pray for our members, church members, and our friends who are not present with us in worship today. We hope that they know that we are with them in spirit, and we long to see them when we can, face to face. We pray for the persistence of healthcare workers and those infected with COVID and those who have lost loved ones, including a young person from Whittier County in the past couple of weeks. Please comfort those loved ones and comfort the families and support everyone who is working to keep us safe and keep things going in our busy society. Please bless Socorro Budenseck, Bill, their family, as she transitions into a healthcare facility. We pray for the family of Charlene Verstade, who passed away last week. Please give your healing grace to Nancy Scherer, Tina Hostetter's grandmother, Connie, who's entered hospice. We pray for Gail Strammel. Please encourage her and give her strength as she fights to regain health. We're grateful for the 5 birthdays in Parker's family this month. And we're grateful for the variety and diversity of people in our country, people with different ideas from whom we can learn. And teach sacrifice to all of us as we work to build a better world for all of us. Please join me in saying the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Give us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, please stand if you are able, and let's pass the peace one to the other, and let each other know how important they are into our lives. Please join me in singing the peace song on the inside back cover of the Black Hymnal.
Thank you.
teach us that what is ours is really yours, and what is yours is really ours. Amen. Our final hymn today is hymn 127, Lo, How a Rose E'er Bloom. 127. Because God is right with us. Every step of the way, God is with us. And there's nowhere we can go where God isn't already there, waiting for us and loving us.